Hello, UDC Firebirds basketball fans, and welcome to game two of our doubleheader action this afternoon, as it's your UDC men's basketball team getting set to take on the men's basketball team from Daemen College. Your UDC men enter this afternoon's game 1-4 on the season, coming off of a very hard-fought two-point loss here at home to Virginia Union and former UDC women's basketball head coach Jay Butler. This afternoon, they take on a Daemen team that is 5-2 on the season, but 0-1 in conference play. They're coming off an overtime loss against LIU Post in their first conference game of the year on Wednesday night. Our own Eric Zidalis caught up with coaches from both teams to preview today's game.
Thanks, Eli. I'm here with assistant men's basketball coach at UDC, Terrell Stokes. Terrell, you guys are 1-4 going into this game, but it's the East Coast Conference schedule now. Is there a sense that this is a new season, new start?
Well, it's always a new season, always trying to get better, you know. So you're opening up the league. You know, you always want to protect your home court and get a win in the league, you know. So if you want to know in the league, everything else don't matter.
What can you tell us about this Daemen team?
Oh, very well coached. You know, I knew Mike for a very long time. He was at Canisius when I was at Loyola. You know, so he has his guys well prepared. You know, they like to shoot a lot of threes. They like to, you know, mix up their defense. So we just got to be prepared and be ready and just play UDC basketball.
All right. You touched on being ready defensively. What else do you need to do to win today?
Well, we got to play our style of basketball. We need to pick up the pace. You know, we need to run them off the three-point line. You know, we just got to score more points than them so we can win the game.
All right. Well, good luck today.
Thank you.
All right. We're here with Daemen head coach Mike McDonald. Mike, your Wildcats are 5-2 on the year, 0-1 in the ECC. This is the longest you have to travel to get to an ECC opponent. Is this a tough gym to play in as well?
Yeah, it's a tough team, tough gym to play in because they got good players. You know, that's what makes a tough gym is when the other team has good players, and they got really good players.
Tell us what you've seen on film from Mike Riley's Firebird squad.
Well, they have a very veteran team. They start four seniors and then a junior. That's like a full house in college basketball right there. And obviously it begins and ends with the point guard. He is outstanding. He gets in the lane, and he keeps everybody on their heels.
Yeah, that's Kasim Chandler. Yes. And who on your side should we look out for?
I don't know. We seem to go game to game. We're never quite sure who it's going to be. So hopefully we'll continue that and be able to have a lot of different guys helping us.
All right. Best of luck today.
All right, thank you.
Eli Perlstein back with you from atop the UDC Sports Complex, getting you set for game two of our doubleheader this afternoon. Your UDC men's basketball team and the men's basketball team from Daemen College. Let's get right to today's starting lineups. And we'll begin with the visiting Daemen College Wildcats, who are led by third-year head coach Mike McDonald, a graduate of St. Bonaventure University back in 1988. He's assisted by Mike Burkham, David Johnson, Xavier Williams, and Ryan Grandis. And here's the starting lineup for Daemen. In the backcourt, they'll go with redshirt senior Supreme Hanna. He stands 6 feet, 165 pounds, from Rochester, New York. Also in the backcourt, sophomore Darius Garvin, who stands 6'1", 180 pounds, from Elmira, New York. And 6'4", redshirt sophomore Dion Hamilton. He is from Rochester, New York, as well. In the front court, they'll go with redshirt freshman Jeff Redband. He's from Batavia, New York, as well as redshirt senior Arif Memetaj. He's from Jamaica, New York. And that lineup for Daemen will be going up against the following starting lineup for your UDC Firebirds, who are led by fourth-year head coach Mike Riley. He's assisted by Terrell Stokes and Anthony Iotti. In the backcourt, the Firebirds will go with four guards, those being senior Kasim Chandler, junior Trayvon Butler, senior Joseph Nickerson, and senior Reggie Sidbury. The front court, the Firebirds will play senior Jayon Troutman. He stands 6'5", 190 pounds, a native of Chicago, Illinois. Our officials this afternoon are Chris Cogna, John Felker, and Michael Ford. Firebirds dressed in their gold jerseys and shorts with Firebirds written across the front in burgundy lettering, burgundy numbers on the front and back of the jerseys. Daemen dressed in black jerseys and shorts with blue numbers with white trim on the back of the jerseys and front. Daemen written across the front of the jerseys. White stripes and a thick blue stripe down these sides with these jerseys and shorts. It will be Jayon Troutman to take the tip for UDC. Going up against Arif Mehmetaj for Daemen. Last time Daemen was in this building, they lost in the ECC Tournament Championship game, 80-63 to St. Thomas Aquinas College. St. Thomas Aquinas off to another good year this year, ranked 7th nationally in Division 2. Sim Chandler controls the ball for UDC, dishes off to Butler. Now Troutman hands off to Chandler. They'll work a weave. Sidbury had a great game against Virginia Union on Wednesday, and a good start for the Firebirds as Nickerson knocks down the three to give UDC the early 3-0 cushion. Daemen trying to answer right back. Layup from Mehmetaj, and he draws the foul as he could not convert the layup from the right side, but did draw contact. Clock stops with 19:28 to go here in the first half of play. Mehmetaj averaging 15.3 points per contest. He is the team's leading scorer. 6 of 8 from the free throw line this season. Good on the first attempt. Got the friendly roll off the front of the rim. As a team, Daemen shooting 76% from the free throw line. Better than the Firebirds 73% thus far this season. Mehmetaj makes them both. It's a 3-2 ball game. 19:24 to go here in this first half of play. Chandler dishes right to Sidbury. The three ball, it is good. And the Firebirds start off 2-for-2 from beyond the arc. They've been shooting 37% from three-point range this season. Compare that to Daemen, who's been shooting 36%. So both teams right about the same clip from three-point range. Nickerson loses it out of bounds, so it will be Daemen basketball with 19:02 remaining here in the first half. Shot clock at 30. Supreme Hannah dishes off to Hamilton. Now driving his red band, and he's whistled for the travel. Trying to enter the lane, took one too many steps. Last time these two teams met, January 29th, 2016, here in D.C. UDC lost that contest 100-89. Two teams split the season series last year with UDC winning in Amherst, New York, which is where Daemen is located, 89-84. That was the only win UDC has collected against Daemen since Daemen entered the ECC at the start of the 13-14 season. Chandler has the ball stripped from him. Great defensive move there. Now wide open for the bunny underneath is Hamilton. That was Darius Garvin with that strip of Chandler. He just ripped the ball out of his hands. It's 8-4 UDC on top, 18:02 to go here in the first half of play. Nickerson drives, tries to kick to Chandler, passes picked off by Garvin, and he goes in for the easy two-hand slam. So lead is down to 2. Daemen bench, very into this one already. Channing defense, defense. Sidbury, the step back 3. Off the back iron, Chandler with the steal. Chandler comes into this game ranked 7th nationally in steals per game with 3.4. He'll drive, up and under move, and it's good off the glass. Great move by Kasim Chandler, a Newark, New Jersey native. Second on the team in scoring right now with 16.6 points per game. Beautiful feed to Mehmetaj. He knows what to do right around the rim. Puts in the easy deuce. 16:56 remaining. Chandler will slow the pace down. Troutman sets the screen. Nickerson thought better of trying to drive in. Now Chandler drives. Contact, doesn't get it to go off the glass. Referees putting his arm straight up, signaling that there was no whistle blown because the defender's arms were straight up and did not go forward. Sidbury, jab steps, screen set by Nickerson. Troutman from the elbow, can't connect. 16-11 remaining here in the first half of play. 2-point UDC lead. Hannah, pump fakes. Delivers left to Hamilton, who drives in, puts up the one-handed shot off the glass and in. We are tied at 10. 15:53 to go. Firebirds 0-1 here at home this season after that 2-point loss to Virginia Union. Firebirds made a spirited comeback attempt in that one after being down by as many as 15 points in the second half. Firebirds have not trailed yet today. Chandler kicks out to Sidbury for three. He got it. 3 3-pointers drilled by the Firebirds thus far. Next dead ball will be our first media timeout of the game. Matt Matosh, nice pump fake, then cannot get the finger roll to fall. But Garvin gets the offensive board. One area the Firebirds have struggled this season is in the rebound department. Now we get a loose ball foul called on Daemen. It's on number 44, Jeff Redband. And that will bring us to our first media timeout. Firebird looking good to start. Up by three with 15:03 remaining. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia television.
The point of the University of the District of Columbia is to allow every individual who walks into our doors to achieve his or her highest level of potential.
It's a melting pot. I grew up in a very diverse country amongst different cultural people, and being at UDC felt like being home.
I think that combination of the international students, and then there's a lot of students here that are coming back to school and their older age. So it's very well-rounded in that way.
So that to be able to combine the quality with the affordability and the diversity makes us something special and unique in higher education. The people that we serve, which are generally DC public school graduates, although we serve students from all over the world and all over the country, part of what has to happen is that they need to see a better place and a better time and a better possibility in their lives, which is why we say that UDC is the place where dreams begin.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship. Found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
Four of this five starters still on the floor for UDC coming out of the media timeout. The one player who just checked in is Anthony Matthews, the junior from Staten Island, New York. He replaces Kasim Chandler. It's 13-10, Firebirds on top, 15:03 to go here in the first half of here in the first half of play. Matthews into the front court. Against a zone defense from the Wildcats. Butler settles for three, and he rattles it in. 4 3-pointers drained thus far for the Firebirds. It's a 16-10 lead with 14:39 remaining. Nickerson able to get his hand on the pass to break it up. Firebirds, however, can't come away with the steal. Nice extended D by UDC. Garvin works it around the perimeter. Hamilton uses a screen by Nemetaj. Now kicks out Redband. Won't hit the three, but an offensive rebound and put back by Hamilton. Firebirds getting out rebounded by more than 10 rebounds per game on average this season. Daemen, though, hasn't been great in the rebound department either. They've been out-rebounded by an average of 5 per game. Hamilton dishes to Redband. Nice pump fake by the basket, and he's able to set himself free for the easy deuce. 19-14, Firebirds by 5, 13:32 to go in the half. Matthews shouting out instructions at the point position. Troutman puts up the J from the elbow, too strong. Rebound collected by Mamatage. Now Garvin has it. Dribbles through a triple team, then has the ball stolen away by Butler. Butler has someone right behind him, able to shed the ball from his defender and put in the underhand lay and off the glass. 13 minutes exactly remaining in the half. Supreme Hanna pump faked the pass before handing it off. Now Hanna gets it back, guarded by Troutman. Feeds down low to Redband. We have a whistle and a defensive foul called on UDC. Team's second of the half. Firebirds will make a substitution. Khalil Jackson checks into the game for the first time, replacing Jayon Troutman. That was the first personal foul on Joseph Nickerson. And so the Wildcats will inbound from the front court baseline. Jaleo Wilkes handling the rock. He just checked in for Daemen. Hanna. Hand off to Wilkes. Now Hamilton drives. Wilkes pump fakes. Finds Mehmetaj in the corner. Good for the triple. Arif Mehmetaj. Showing why he leads this Daemen team in scoring. Four Daemen players who average in double digits in terms of points per game. As a team, the Wildcats average 71.3 points per game this season. Daemen coming off again an overtime loss against LIU Post. They lost that game 73-70. And we have reached the under 12 media timeout. Firebirds still in control of this one, up 21-17. You're watching UDC Firebirds basketball here on University of the District of Columbia television.
Being an educator is the best job in the world. My philosophy about education is maybe a little bit different. I firmly believe that education is not simply about getting our questions answered. That's probably what we typically think about when we speak about education. There is knowledge, and there is me, and I don't have that knowledge, and so how do I get that knowledge? Well, that's certainly is a point. But I think there's an important step before we even can have our questions answered. We must have our answers questioned. That is about questioning what I already think I know. That has to be challenged first. That's probably the most important, the most difficult, but also the most rewarding part of being an educator.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Thank you.
Anderson, Matthews, Jackson, Chandler, and Sidbury out on the court for UDC. Coming out of that second media timeout of the half is Sidbury to inbound, gets it into Jackson. Now Matthews working with it on the perimeter. Sidbury back to Matthews. Pump fakes, sets himself free right as the shot clock was set to expire. Can't convert from the free throw line. So it remains a 4-point game. Hamilton drives on Nickerson, kicks out wide. Metmetaj draws the reach-in foul on Matthews. Firebirds' third team foul of the half. First personal committed by Matthews, the native of Staten Island, New York. Bunch of subs coming in for Daemen. Jesse Ulka, Alex Miljanovic, and Xavier Long. Is Wilkes to inbound. Gets it into Alka. Now Wilkes works against Chandler. This Daemen team looking to snap a two-game losing skid. Their last win was actually against an opponent that the Firebirds have already played this season. Daemen won at home against Slippery Rock 69-57. Firebirds, their second to last game, lost at Slippery Rock 83-60. So their one common opponent this season, much different results against them. First of two games they'll play against each other this season. Next time these two teams will meet will be January 21st in Amherst, New York, which is where Daemen is located. Firebirds will be left alone in the backcourt to bring the ball up. 10:50 to go in the half. Here's Chandler. Dribbling left, handing off to Jackson. Oh, pardon me, that's Cameron Outlaw. He's now into the game as well for UDC. Nickerson drives. Too strong on the short jumper. Still a 4-point game, 21-17, 10:22 remaining. Hit a little bit of a lull here. Lolka swings on top of the arc, now around the perimeter, into the hands of Wilkes. Wilkes drives, may have been bumped on the shot, results in an air ball. Jackson down court for UDC, no look pass to Nickerson, the reverse comes up short. Gotta like that look from Jackson to Nickerson, just don't like the end result. Wilkes, too strong on the shot from the paint. There to clean up the miss is Miljanovic, the redshirt junior from Belgrade, Serbia, who averages 7.7 points per game with the easy two to make it a 2-point game. Matthews to a cutting Outlaw. And the Firebirds getting some good looks around the rim, just too strong on many of their attempts. And now it's a tie game after that layup from the left side by Xavier Long. So we're tied at 21, 9:21 remaining in the half. Terrific start to this one by the Firebirds. 4 3-pointers hit in the half. They're missing some good looks of late. Jackson drives, gets bumped, converts a pretty difficult shot to make. So they're missing some easy looks, making the difficult ones. And it's Khalil Jackson, the junior from Brooklyn, New York, who will head to the line to try and complete the 3-point play. Trayvon Butler will check back into the game for UDC, replacing Cameron Outlaw. It's interesting. Seems as though head coach Mike Riley starting to mix his returners from last year more with the new guys, more this game than he did in the Firebirds' previous game, that 2-point loss here at home against Virginia Union. That being said, all five starters for UDC were their five returners from last year. Pretty clearly defined starting group. Garvin finds Miljanovic, who loses the ball along the baseline. It was recovered by UDC's Reggie Sidbury, but then he stepped on the baseline, so the ball will be right back in the hands of the Wildcats. 8:48 remaining in this first half of play. Eli Perlstein with you. Earlier this afternoon, UDC women collected their second win of the season, a two-point win over the women of Daemen College in their first conference game of the year. Layup won't go. Troutman secures the board and saves it inbound to Butler. Butler hands off to Chandler. Chandler drives, dishes wide. Now Matthews loses the ball along the baseline. Seems as though the Firebirds are playing with some extra pep in their step compared to their game on Wednesday night. The ball is moving crisply. The cuts seem more precise. I like the way that they have come out here in the first half. Hamilton works it around the perimeter, receives the ball back in the paint, and then is stripped by Butler. Butler head to Chandler, decides not to go up the layup, instead gets it to Sidbury, who's unable to hit the three. Sidbury had a great game against Virginia Union on Wednesday. He had 16 points, one of four Firebirds in double digits. Joseph Nickerson led the way with 19 points. He's the team's leading scorer on the season. Pump fake by Hannah. Now feeds Metmetage down low. We have a defensive foul called on UDC. Call goes against Reggie Sidbury. So it's the Firebirds' 14th foul, Sidbury's second. And we've reached the under eight media timeout. Firebirds ahead by two, 23-21. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia Television.
You know, we take students at UDC from where they are. It doesn't matter about your background, what education you have. What we do is we plot a course for you to graduate. We got a lot of graduates that have come from UDC. They're in 42 cities, they're in 32 states, they're all over the world. Because we don't just train you from books. We train you how to make a living. We train you how to make a difference in your community. We give you a career. It's just not education, it's application. That's why if you're really interested in architecture and it's your passion, you need to come to UDC. I mean, if you're interested in being the best you can be, if you're interested in a lucrative career, if you're interested in making a difference, if you're interested in having a cause that's beyond yourself, then UDC is the place to be.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship. Found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
Eli Perlstein back with you. 7:42 remaining here in the first half. It's been a good, close, competitive game thus far. Firebirds coming into the season, predicted by the coaches in the ECC to finish fourth out of the 10 teams after a third place finish in the conference a year ago. Daemen was predicted to finish fifth. So these teams predicted to be pretty even this year. Last touch by Daemen will be Firebirds basketball. There are five other games involving East Coast Conference schools going on this afternoon. One final from earlier. St. Thomas Aquinas squeaking out a two-point win at Molloy, 72-70. St. Thomas Aquinas, as I mentioned earlier, the highest-ranked ECC team nationally. They're ranked seventh in the nation. That layup ties things up at 23 apiece, 6:56 remaining. Matthews hands off to Nickerson. He feeds Chandler. Chandler drives, gets bumped to the ground, but cannot get the underhand layup to fall. It was halfway home, folks, before rimming out. The two free throws will be coming up for Kasim Chandler. Chandler, 69% free throw shooter on the season. He's a perfect 6 for 6 from the free throw line. The Firebirds' two-point loss on Wednesday night. Chandler sinks the first, averaging 16.6 points per game. Transferred to the UDC from Quinnipiac prior to last season. And he gets them both in this trip to the line. Matt Mataj able to control the loose ball. And then a three-pointer by Hannah gives Daemen its first lead of the game at 26-25. Crowd has gone silent here at the UDC Sports Complex. Daemen bench, however, not so. They're stressing defense to their teammates on the floor. Butler, the three, gives UDC the lead right back. So a short-lived Daemen advantage. 28-26, 6:04 remaining here in the first half of play. Garvin settles for the three and connects. So teams trading threes. It's back to a one-point Wildcat lead, 29-28. Chandler over to Butler. Now Nickerson dribbles right, dishes left to Chandler. Had the choice to use a screen by Nickerson, decided not to use it, and winds up getting called for the travel. Darius Garvin will check out of the game for Daemen. Jaleo Wilkes in for him. It's Wilkes, Supreme Hannah, Arif Metmetaj, Deion Hamilton, and Jeff Redband on the floor for Daemen. Hannah works it to Memetaj. Now down low, Redband. Kicks on top to Hannah for three. Can they make it three in a row? No, they can't. Too strong, but an offensive rebound by Redband. Now underneath Hamilton with the layup from the left side. It's 31-28, Daemen on top, 5:08 remaining. Jeff Redband was named the ECC Rookie of the Week on Monday for the Wildcats. Chandler drives, can't convert the short shot. Now Hannah has his pass back to Memetaj, deflected out of bounds by Troutman. Firebirds themselves have picked up one weekly award this season. Joseph Nickerson was named the ECC Player of the Week on November 14th. Firebirds 1-5 against Daemen. Their six meetings with the Wildcats since the Wildcats joined the ECC at the start of the 13-14 season. The one win coming last season in Amherst, New York. The drive and bucket is good by Hamilton. Chance at a three-point play. Khalil Jackson checks in the game for UDC, replacing Trayvon Butler. Butler growing out his hair since last season, sporting a new do here in 2016-17.
Free throw rims out. Nickerson grabs the board for UDC. So it remains a 5-point game, 4:20 remaining in the half. Jackson open, decides to pass up a shot. Now Nickerson from way downtown misses to the left. Wilkes to Hannah. He can't get the three either. Then the ball poked away from Hamilton out of bounds. And it will stay Wildcats basketball. Mike McDonald shouting out instructions from in front of the Daemen bench. It's been the head man at Daemen for the last couple of years. In his 20th year overall as a collegiate head coach. Effective move by Nemetaj, chucking the ball at Troutman because he realized that time was nearly going to expire on him. We have reached the under four media timeout. Firebirds trailing by five. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia television.
I have the best job of anyone I know. I am surrounded by intensely committed, hard-charging lawyers for social change, lawyers who care about social justice, staff who are here at the law school because of our mission. Our law school has a completely different, pervasive educational methodology. We learn by doing. So instead of taking a course where you read books and articles about juveniles enmeshed in the criminal justice system, at the David A. Clark School of Law, you represent children charged with crimes or children who are in the abuse and neglect system or children with special education needs in court or in administrative hearings. You actually, as a student with close faculty supervision, change their lives. And that's how you learn.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Have Troutman, Sidbury, Chandler, Jackson, and Nickerson on the court to start off the final 4 minutes of this first half. Wildcats basketball. The unit that's out on the court for UDC is the starting five minus one. Wide open for a 3-point look is Wilkes, but he can't connect. Firebirds got away with one there. Cross court pass to Sidbury from the corner, in and out. Nickerson bumped as he soared in for the rebound and gets the putback to make it 33-30. 3:30 remaining in the half. Wilkes hands off. Now Nemetaj guarded tightly by Troutman. Long works it to the baseline and then steps on the baseline for the turnover. 3:17 left in the half. Nickerson inbounds to Chandler, who's been left alone to bring it up. This Daemen team not really a pressing team, as Troutman gets the friendly roll on the jumper from the free throw line, and UDC within one. Firebirds have led for the majority of this first half. It's been a late spurt by the Wildcats that given them what stands right now as a one-point lead. Shot by Memetaj in and out. So Firebirds now with a chance to reclaim the lead they once held. Chandler drives, bumped on the layup attempt. He will head to the line to shoot a pair. Chandler making a living at the line. It's 2 for 2 this afternoon, 6 for 6 in his last game from the free throw line. This is when he's most effective, is when he's driving, getting to the basket, and drawing contact. Subs in for Daemen. Alex Miljinovic and Jesse Lalka back in. This Daemen team lists a total of 19 players on their roster. Only 14 have appeared in a game, however. That is quite some depth compared to the 11 players total that the Firebirds have on their roster. Daemen's appearance in the East Coast Conference tournament held here at UDC last year, their first postseason appearance as a full-fledged member of NCAA Division II. Foul called, I believe it will be on Khalil Jackson. Looked like he got a lot of ball and really slapped the ball back into the head of Supreme Hannah, but they saw the refs, that is, saw the head move back and called a foul as a result. Pardon me, they called the foul on Trayvon Butler. It was Jackson who got the block. Hannah hits the first free throw. We're knotted up at 34. Jeff Redband checks out of the game for Daemen. In for him comes Xavier Long. Long's in there with Hannah, Miljinovic, Lalka, and Wilkes. 1 point Wildcat lead. 2:15 remaining. Screen set by Troutman. Chandler hands off to Butler. Now, intended pass from Troutman to Chandler goes out of bounds, so it's Daemen basketball. We got a timeout called by the Firebirds. They'll have a timeout taken away if they don't use it here in the first half. So they decide to use one with 2:06 remaining, and the Firebirds trailing by one. Folks, at the University of the District of Columbia, the entire city is our campus. From the new community college and workforce development programs to the extension services and more, the university is active in every ward of the city, educating and enriching the lives of students, neighbors, and stakeholders. For more information, visit the UDC website at www.udc.edu. The Wildcats ball from the near sideline. An inbounds pass deflected by Butler. So even though the Firebirds don't wind up coming away with the basketball, still an effective timeout called by UDC. And now reach in foul called on Kasim Chandler. That's the seventh team foul. So 1-1 free throws coming up for the Wildcats. It is Breon Harris getting his first minutes of the game at the line. Free throw attempt too strong, and Chandler somehow comes away with the rebound off the missed free throw. He had to soar in the air to grab that one. Smallest guy on the court coming away with the rebound from the missed free throw. Doesn't happen all that often. Butler open for a split second. Let's fly the three, can't hit. Nickerson has the putback attempt blocked. We'll have another opportunity at it, and this time he scores off the glass. Makes it 36-35, 1:25 left in the half. Harris into the front court. Swings a pass left to Alka. Now Miljinovic. Pass intended down low for Harris, picked off. Nickerson, no look pass. Beautiful ball movement by the Firebirds, and it's Troutman with the finish with his right hand off the glass. And now some subs coming in for Daemen. Four subs, or five coming in to be exact. Hannah, Garvin, Red Band, and Coach Mike McDonald. Not happy with that last minute or so play from his Wildcats. Hannah finds Hamilton, backs up. Now swings left to Hannah. Hannah works it to Redbend. Hamilton working against Jackson. Good defense by Jackson. Just two on the shot clock. The three-pointer as the shot clock expires. And Nemetaj able to draw the foul. Can't let them bail out of that situation like that. Tough, tough defense all through the shot clock, and then they got bailed out with the foul call. 26.2 seconds, all that remains in the half, so shot clock will be turned off the next possession. Nemetaj, three free throws to come. He's able to hit the first. Came into this game 6 of 8 from the free throw line. He's from Jamaica, New York, stands 6'7", 220 pounds, redshirt senior. One more attempt to try and tie things up. Alka and Long back in for Daemen, as well as Wilkes. Nemetaj makes all three, so a costly foul right as the shot clock was about to expire. We are tied up at 38. Been a back and forth first half. Firebirds have led for most of it. And overall, very well played first half by both teams. 9 seconds left. Chandler starts to make his move, drives right in the lane, finds an open Jackson for three. He's got it. Makes it 41-38. As we head to intermission, Firebirds with a strong first half performance, trying to notch their second win ever against this Daemen College team. We'll step aside, come back in a bit, tell you about the first half statistics. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia television.
As an integral part of the University of the District of Columbia, the Department of Intercollegiate Athletics provides experiences that enhance the comprehensive development of our student athletes. With a commitment to excellence, we embrace the overall mission of the NCAA with an emphasis on Division II to provide growth opportunities through academic achievement, learning in high-level athletic competition, and development of positive societal attitudes and service to community. In addition, we are committed to providing a game environment which respects fairness, courtesy, and ethical conduct towards others. We are the University of the District of Columbia, an advanced public system of higher learning where dreams begin.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship. Found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports. We'll be right back.
set to start half number two. You're at the UDC Sports Complex between your UDC Firebirds men's basketball team and the men's basketball team from Daemen College. A quick look at the first half statistics. Those the Firebirds shooting 7 of 11 from downtown. That's 63.6%. UDC shot 50% total from the field. They were 4 of 5 from the free throw line. Daemen shot nearly as well as the Firebirds did from the field overall, 48.3%. Made just one fewer field goal, and really that's the difference in this game. Daemen, 3 of 10 from 3, however, just 30%. They were 7 of 9 from the free throw line, so they did get there more. Leading scorer for UDC with 11 points in the first half was Reggie Sidbury. Joseph Nickerson, their leading rebounder, with 5. He also led the team with 3 steals. Arif Mehmetaj and Deion Hamilton tied for the team lead for Daemen, each with 10 points. Hamilton and Miljanovic tied for the team lead in rebounds with 4 each. Daemen with the first possession of this second half. It's Hannah making his way into the lane, then passing out. Now Hamilton finds a cutting Garvin, who's able to finish right by the rim. So Firebird's lead has been trimmed to 1 with 19:30 to go here in the second half of play. Chandler gets a screen set by Troutman. Now Nickerson works it to Butler. Chandler drives right of the lane, started to fall to the ground. Troutman recovers, gets it off to Butler, whose 3 rims out. It'll be interesting to see if the Firebirds can keep their hot shooting from downtown up here in the second half. You know they're going to try a bevy of 3s. Nice look down low for Deion Hamilton, who puts the Wildcats ahead by 1, 42-41. During halftime, Firebirds didn't spend much time in the locker room, came out only after a few minutes. Meanwhile, Daemen was in the locker room till there was about 2 minutes left on the clock, signaling just 2 minutes till the start of the second half. So different approaches by the two coaches in terms of how long they keep their teams in the locker room at halftime. To whose benefit, who knows? It'll be Sidbury to inbound. Sidbury can have that monster first half with 11 points. That's back-to-back games that Sidbury has really led the way for the Firebirds in the first half. And he continues here with his first shot of the second half. 3-pointer drained by Sidbury. He now has 14. Sidbury spending his entire collegiate career here at UDC. Mehmetaj unable to hit the easy look from down low. Firebirds now a chance to extend their lead. Nickerson to Sidbury, he'll try again and he makes another triple. Back-to-back threes by Sidbury, now with 17 points to lead all scorers. 5 of 7 from downtown, he's feeling it. And when a guy's feeling it like that, just gotta keep giving him the ball. Should be their game plan, at least the next few trips down court for UDC. Hannah with the answer, the layup from the right side, makes it a 3-point game. 17:42 to go here in the second half. Chandler dribbles right, looking for Sidbury, now guarded tightly by Redmond. Troutman's open, however, from the elbow, and he connects. Going to guard Sidbury tight, find another option. They did just that with Troutman. He's able to nail that open look. So 5-point UDC lead, 17:17 to go in the half. Hannah looks for Redband, the 3 from the right side, won't go. Rebound controlled by Nickerson for UDC. Gets it ahead to Chandler, had it poked away into the hands of Butler. Sidbury pump fakes the 3, drives, kicks out, Nickerson wide open, and he hits the 3 ball. 4 straight shots hit by UDC, and their lead is 8. The Firebirds coming out strong here in the second half. This is the largest lead of the game for either team. Firebirds led by 7 a couple of times in the first half. Never by 8. So that 8-point lead now down to 6.
Troutman trying to extend it back to eight, can't hit the layup. Back the other way, Hamilton has the ball stripped from behind. Terrific closing speed there. Great D by UDC, taking away that would-be easy look. Hannah, trapped in the corner, gets out of it. Pass intended for Nemetaj, poked away. Now it'll be Garvin to try an inbound for Daemen. He gets it in successfully. Nemetaj on top of the arc, works against Troutman, fakes the three. Or fakes the look at the three, at least. Now Hamilton pulls the trigger, but it's too strong. Back the other way, Sidbury will try again. This time it rims out. Two on one the other way. Hannah cannot finish, but draws the foul on Sidbury. Sidbury with two personals in the first half. This is foul number three committed by him, and he might have to take a seat despite how well he's been shooting here in the second half. It's the first team foul for UDC. Brings us to our under 16 media timeout. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia television.
Building an advanced public system of higher learning that serves the community of the District of Columbia. We selected all of those words very carefully because they all have important meanings. Because none of it really works unless you have a public higher education system that can connect it all together. Well, one of the best kept secrets about the University of the District of Columbia is that we have many quality programs. Our workforce development unit is of a high quality and puts people in jobs each and every day. Our land grant unit, which is serving constituents all over the district. We're the only urban land grant institution in the country. I think that we have all the pieces that we can put together in a way that will allow us to take best practices, best tools, and really wipe the slate clean and redesign ourselves as an advanced public system of higher learning that can serve the district in a way that allows us to be a model of higher education in a city that wants to be a model city for the rest of the country.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Troutman, Chandler, Nickerson, Butler, and Matthews on the court for UDC. So Sidbury will take a seat with those three fouls. It'll be Supreme Hannah headed to the free throw line for Daemen. Hannah came into this game 12 of 16 from the free throw line. Was able to hit the first. As a team, Daemen 7 of 9 from the free throw line in the first half. Hannah now a perfect 3 of 3 from the line this game. Gets the second as well. He now has 11 points. The third Daemen player in double figures. He has 11. Hamilton has 12. And Nemetaj has 10. Firebirds throw it away. That will be Wildcats basketball. 11th turnover for UDC, same number that Daemen has committed. Both teams with 8 points off turnovers. Nemetaj gets it to Hamilton. Now back to Nemetaj. He gets into the lane, goes up right-handed, and good off the backboard. The once 8-point lead for UDC has been cut down to 2 with 15:02 left in the second half. Firebirds able to hit 4 shots in a row to get that 8-point cushion, including 2 threes. Butler will try the open look. Swish! So lead back out to 5. 11 3-pointer hit by the Firebirds in 17 attempts this ball game. Garvin hands it off. Now Hannah. Bounce pass to Memetage, has it stripped away by Nickerson. He races ahead of the pack, shields the ball with his body, puts in the layup and draws the foul. Great job by Nickerson. He was really neck and neck with his defender, was able to get a step on him and then shielded the ball perfectly. Great finish off the backboard. Now a chance at a 3-point play. Joseph Nickerson now with 12 points. Nickerson and Sidbury, the two Firebirds in double digits in the point column. It's 58-50. 14-18 remaining in the ball game. Memetage over to Long. Now Garvin, the 3. Too strong. Memetage, the offensive board. Won't get it to fall. Daemen in the first half out rebounded the Firebirds by 3, 18-15. Long's pass picked off by Nickerson. Again ahead of the pack, and he'll finger roll it in. Makes it 60-50. So Firebirds now enjoying their largest lead of the afternoon by 10. They're looking for their second ever win over Daemen. Since Daemen joined the conference back in 2013-2014. Chance to extend their lead. Butler hands off to Chandler. Chapman sets the screen. Chandler back to Butler. Again to Chandler. Firebirds looking to improve to 1-0 in conference play. Wildcats looking to avoid an 0-2 start to conference play. Butler can't hit the layup from the right side. Firebirds missed a few bunnies in the first half as well. They were making some difficult shots, but unable to hit the easy ones, and we got a defensive foul called on UDC. Defender was in the circle. So free throws coming up for Xavier Long, the redshirt junior from Brooklyn, New York, who's only averaging 1.9 points per game this season. This is Long's first trip to the free throw line this afternoon. He has just 2 points today. Kyle Williams awaits to check in for the Firebirds. Now a couple of the referees huddling up. I guess confirming the call was correct. They decide it was. Long 5 of 13 from the free throw line this season. So if you're a UDC fan, you wouldn't mind seeing him there a few more times. Does hit the first, however. Jayon Troutman checks out of the game for UDC as Williams came in for him. Firebirds 15-14 a year ago. They've continued to improve each year under head coach Mike Riley. Butler gets it to Jackson, or pardon me, Williams. Now Matthews, the deep two, in and out. Hamilton drives. Good off the glass. And the lead that was once 10, now down to 6, with 12:28 to go. Crowd has gone silent here at the UDC Sports Complex. It was a very animated crowd earlier today during the women's game. UDC women collecting their second win of the season by 2 over the women from Daemen College. Firebirds also looking for their second win of the season overall. Three-pointer knocked down by Supreme Hannah, and the lead is trimmed to 3. Just a couple minutes ago, Firebirds had their lead trimmed to 2. They were able to get that back up in a hurry with a nice little run to extend it to 10. Now the lead trimmed to 3. UDC wanting to call a timeout to make sure that momentum goes back in their favor. Folks, the University of the District of Columbia is the only public university in the nation's capital and the only urban land-grant university in the United States. UDC is comprised of a community college, a school of engineering and applied sciences, a school of business and public administration, a college of arts and sciences, a college of agriculture, and an urban sustainability and environmental sciences college, and the David A. Clark School of Law. For more information, visit the UDC website at www.udc.edu. Also, be sure to follow UDC Athletics on Facebook, on Twitter at UDC Firebird Fans, and on YouTube at UDC Athletics 1. For UDC, it will be Nickerson, Matthews, Williams, Butler, and Jackson in the game. Jackson will be the one to inbound from the near sideline. Walka, Hannah, Wilkes, Hamilton, and a new player, Alex Borges, in the game for the first time for Daemen. Jackson got to pass off to Nickerson. Williams trying to post up. Williams now comes up, sets the screen. Matthews decides to go the other way. Gets by his defender nonetheless. Hits the layup off the glass to make it 62-57. So lead back to 5. 11:26 to go. Alex Borges, who's in the game for the first time for Daemen. 6'6 senior from Erie, Pennsylvania. Pump fake by Walka. Pump fake by Hamilton. He drives, feeds Walka underneath, who gets hammered on a layup attempt. Nickerson left his feet and couldn't do anything but come down on Walka. And that will bring us to the under 12 media timeout. Remember, folks, that last one was a timeout called by UDC. So this is the under 12 media timeout. Firebirds leading by 5. Free throws coming up for Law Club. This is UDC Firebirds men's basketball on the University of the District of Columbia television.
You know, we take students at UDC from where they are. It doesn't matter about your background, what education you have. What we do is we plot a course for you to graduate. We got a lot of graduates that have come from UDC. They're in 42 cities, they're in 32 states, they're all over the world. Because we don't just train you from books. We train you how to make a living. We train you how to make a difference in your community. We give you a career. It's just not education, it's application. That's why if you're really interested in architecture and it's your passion, you need to come to UDC. I mean, if you're interested in being the best you can be, if you're interested in a lucrative career, if you're interested in making a difference, If you're interested in having a cause that's beyond yourself, then UDC is the place to be.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship. Found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
So free throws coming up for Jesse Lalka, who coming into this game had not attempted a free throw. He's unable to hit the first. Daemen has a team 14, make that now 12 of 15 from the free throw line. So Lalka hits one of two. Matthews into the front court for the Firebirds. 10:57 remaining. Butler swings it to Nickerson. Deep three-pointer. The hand in his face. Not sure about that shot selection. They had time on the shot clock. Could have worked for something better. So lead remains four. Borges gets it to Hannah. Now Wilkes tried to get himself freed open. Firebirds with many hands in there to deflect the pass, but they turn it right back over. Hannah ahead of the pack, and has the shot blocked off the backboard by Jackson. That looked pretty clean to me. But they call a foul on Jackson. I'm not sure for what. Maybe he got him with his lower body. But certainly up top, that was clean and impressive. So now it's Supreme Hannah headed to the free throw line. That is the Firebirds' fifth foul of the half compared to just one committed by Daemen. So that's something to keep note of. It's the first foul committed by Jackson. Kyle Williams checks out of the game. Reggie Sidbury back in for him also. Nickerson now into the free throw lane. Remember, Sidbury playing with those three fouls. So fouls may become a storyline here late in this one. Firebirds already four more team fouls committed in the half. Two away from 1-1 the rest of the way. Matthews gets to Nickerson. Nickerson, Jackson for three. Rims out. And deflected out of bounds by the Firebirds. It's Daemen basketball with 10:06 to go in the ball game. The flow of this game has become a little choppy in the last couple of minutes. Borges gets it to Hamilton. Now attempted feed to Borges. He gets it underneath the hoop. And it's blocked from behind by Jackson. Firebirds with numbers, 2-on-1. Nickerson, the pretty move, but he can't finish with the finger roll. Did everything right but the finish. Back the other way, three-pointer. And how do you like that? A five-point swing. Could have been two the other way. Instead, the missed shot leads to transition for Daemen, and Supreme Hannah sinking the three to give the Wildcats a one-point lead. 9:17 left, and that finger roll by Nickerson in and out. So close to being a different story. Matthews to Jackson. He drives, kicks wide. Sidbury to Nickerson, who drives, tries a left-handed shot, didn't get to the rim. Back the other way, Hamilton too strong on his layup attempt. So both teams missing some easy looks in the last minute. Matthews to Butler. Jackson underneath, double teamed. Matthews pump fakes, defender didn't bite. And now Nickerson will have the offense reset. He drives into a pile of three defenders and draws a blocking foul. Second team foul committed by the Wildcats in the half. And it's Joseph Nickerson headed to the free throw line. Or pardon me, ball will stay on the floor. Firebirds will inbound from the front court baseline. Nickerson checks out of the game for UDC. Chandler is in. Chandler works against Hannah. Gets it to Sidbury. Back to Chandler. He finds Sidbury on the far wing, who drives in. And the ball slapped away out of bounds. Stays Firebirds basketball. And the shot clock will be reset. That was a foul called on that reach-in that slapped the ball away. Foul call on number 11, Jesse Lauka, his first personal. Team's third. Lauka checks out of the game. Darius Garvin back in for him. Sidbury inbounds to Jackson. Now Matthews. Bounce pass down low to Chandler, who's fouled on the layup attempt. So I said, look at the foul disparity. That may become an issue. Well, all of a sudden, now just one fewer foul committed by Daemen than UDC, with the three successive fouls called on the Wildcats in this trip down floor for UDC. Again, here is Kasim Chandler from the free throw line. Firebirds as a team, 5 of 6 from the free throw line, make that 6 of 7. Chandler, a big reason why. He is a perfect now 5 of 5. So he's made 11 in a row over the last two games, make that 12. Chandler now with 8 points. 3 for the Firebirds are in double figures. Sidbury, Nickerson, and Butler. Garvin worked it to Wilkes. Wilkes drives on Chandler, gets the bucket and the foul. The clock stops with 7:51 remaining. We've reached the under 8 media timeout. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia Television.
Public education is an opportunity like no other. When it works, it's absolutely magical. When it works on this campus, the magic is just unending. I am a product of public education. I went to public schools from K through graduate school. And I can't imagine district residents wouldn't have the same options that I had as a kid in the state of Ohio. I think that UDC is special because it marries the best of all that is Washington, D.C. When you cross the campus, you cross students from every ward of the city, every type of neighborhood. We represent, in terms of student populations, about 100 countries around the world. So you can hear almost any language. You can see every color of the rainbow on this campus. You can hear every kind of dream of hope. You can hear every kind of story of triumph.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship. Found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
The
More free throws coming up for the Wildcats. They're in the lead by one, 65-64. Firebirds have led by as many as 10 in the second half. Wilkes at the line, and he's able to complete the three-point play. 66-64, 7:48 remaining. Firebirds looking for their second win of the season. Wildcats looking for their sixth, but their first in conference play. Jackson drives, underhand, laying is good. Khalil Jackson having a much better game today than he did on Wednesday night against Virginia Union. He's got seven. Firebirds and Wildcats now knotted up. Baseline jumper won't go, it's short. Now Firebirds with numbers the other way. Three on two, and it's Chandler with the finish from the left side. Makes it 68-66, 7:08 remaining. Here's Hannah into the front court. Mehmetaj works against Jackson. Pump fakes what would be a shot from about halfway between the circles. That got a chuckle from some. Now Hannah, ooh, nifty move along the baseline to set himself free. Puts in the layup from the right side. Tied at 68, 6:37 to go. Just get the feeling this is gonna be a nail biter till the end. Hope you've got some nails left to bite. Sidbury, the foul away. Oh, what a game he's put together. Now 19 for Sidbury. He's 7 of 10 from the field, shooting at a 70% clip. Garvin swings right to Hannah. Screen set by Mehmetaj. Hannah, the step back, deep two in and out, soaring in for the offensive board was Wilkes. He couldn't convert. Now finally the Firebirds come away with the rebound. I-49 left, pass deflected out of bounds. Stay UDC basketball. Wilkes showing some athleticism as he soared in for that offensive rebound. No, it didn't result in anything, but was impressive nonetheless. Butler inbounds to Chandler. 20 on the shot clock. Jackson sets the screen. Chandler kicks out to Matthews. Now Jackson drives left of the lane. Draws the foul. Jackson, the junior from Brooklyn, New York, who transferred to UDC from Hostos Community College, certainly has some size and length to him. He's listed at 6'4", 190 pounds. He looks even longer than that. Got some guard moves to him. Jackson, good on the first attempt. Make it 71-68. Nickerson checks in, replaces Anthony Matthews. Jayon Troutman now to the scorer's table. Likely will check in for Jackson. Free throw is good. Jackson does indeed check out as Troutman comes in. So it's now the starting unit that's back out on the court for UDC. And Chandler, Troutman, Sidbury, Nickerson, and Butler. And Firebirds pressing. Try and make things a little more difficult. Give the Wildcats a different look. But they are able to get it across half court. Hannah swings to Hamilton, back to Hannah. Uses a screen by Mehmetaj. In the corner, Garvin the three, and rattles it home. And the lead is cut to one, 72-71. 5:11 left. Both these teams average in the 70s when it comes to points per game. Right now, the flow favoring UDC a little bit more. They average about 5 points more per game than does Daemen. Ball is lost out of bounds with 4:55 remaining. Daemen still with all three of their timeouts left for this final 5 minutes. Firebirds with two remaining. We've got one more media timeout as well.
Garvin drives, puts up the layup attempt, too strong off the glass. Almost a costly turnover there between Sid Berry and Chandler. A little bit of miscommunication in the backcourt. Chandler has the shot blocked. Terrific defense by Garvin, but Firebirds recover. Now they'll reset the offense with 10 on the shot clock. Nickerson drives. He had Trapman going with him. Butler the three, short. And now a chance for Daemen to retake the lead. Memetaj, the three, no good. Butler, smallest guy on the court, secures the rebound. 4:05 remaining. Firebirds in another battle for the second straight game. Firebirds have played a number of close ones. Sidbury the three, this time won't go. Another opportunity for the Wildcats to take the lead. An easy look for Memetaj, and that makes it 73-72. Timeout called. So Wildcats call the timeout. This is not a media timeout, just a timeout called by Daemen. Leaves them with two timeouts left. It's a 30-second timeout called by the Wildcats. I mentioned a number of close games for UDC. They played a six-point game, a six-point loss at Bloomfield on November 19th. They lost by five in their first game at Philadelphia University. And then, of course, the two-point loss here at home against Virginia Union on Wednesday night. So they are battle-tested. A lone win for the Firebirds was in blowout fashion, 94-71 against Chestnut Hill, the first weekend of the season on November 13th. Firebirds will remain here at home, take on Roberts Wesleyan on Wednesday night in their next contest. That will be broadcast on University of the District of Columbia television as well. That'll be a doubleheader that night. Men and women both doing battle with Roberts Wesleyan that night. Chandler walks it up court for UDC. Dribbles left, hands off to Sidbury. Now Jackson. Over to Nickerson. He drives and draws the foul. With nine on the shot clock, Nickerson able to get himself to the free throw line. And now we've reached the under four media timeout, final one of the game, I promise. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia television.
The whole point of the University of the District of Columbia is to allow every individual who walks into our doors to achieve his or her highest level of potential.
It's a melting pot. I grew up in a very diverse country amongst different cultural people, and being at UDC felt like being home.
I think that combination of the international students, and then there's a lot of students here that are coming back to school and their older age. So it's very well-rounded in that way.
So that to be able to combine the quality with the affordability and the diversity makes us something special and unique in higher education. The people that we serve, which are generally DC public school graduates, although we serve students from all over the world and all over the country, part of what has to happen is that they need to see a better place and a better time and a better possibility in their lives, which is why we say that UDC is the place where dreams begin.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
So Joseph Nickerson headed to the free throw line. So we get set to play the final 3:19 of regulation. Firebirds trailing by one. UDC shot well from the free throw line this afternoon. 9 of 10 as a team. Nickerson with 15 points in this game. He's 1 of 1 from the free throw line this afternoon. Good on the first attempt. Nickerson, Sidbury, Butler, and Chandler, the four in double digits for UDC. Hannah, Metmetaj, Hamilton, and Garvin, the four in double digits scoring-wise for Daemen. Nickerson hits them both to give UDC the one-point lead in this back-and-forth affair. No lead larger than 10 points in this game. Firebirds enjoyed that advantage early on here in this second half. Hamilton pump fakes, has Jackson out on him. Jackson's been playing some good defense for UDC. Stands his ground and forces a jump ball. Jackson, terrific defensive stand on Hamilton, stayed right with him. Got a hand in there to force the jump ball. And as a result, a turnover for Daemen, their 15th, two more than the Firebirds. As for their 14 previous turnovers, resulting in 13 UDC points. Chandler, jab steps, screen set by Jackson. He drives in the lane, and that is a travel violation called on Chandler. Maybe could have also called that an offensive foul in terms of lowering his shoulder into his defender, trying to force the issue. So remains a one-point UDC lead, 2:34 remaining. Garvin into the front court, hands off to Hamilton. Hamilton finds Hannah, screen set by Metmetaj. Hannah, double team. Now Metmetaj finds a wide open Garvin, passes up the shot, however. Hannah, the three, no good. The rebound deflected out of bounds and stays Daemen basketball. Wildcats now 6 of 19 from three. It's around 30%. Firebird shooting much better from distance, 11 of 21. Inbounds pass to Metmetaj. She drives. Won't go. Layup won't go, that is. With 2:02 left. The Firebirds now a chance to extend. Chance of defense coming from the Daemen bench. Daemen being located up in Amherst, New York. Not too many Daemen faithful in the building this afternoon. It would be a long trip. Nickerson, the step back jumper, won't go. And it remains a 1 point UDC cushion. Nail biting time has commenced, folks. Metmetaj fouled from behind. Believe that will be on Jackson. And indeed it will be. So stops the clock with a minute 26. Puts Metmetaj at the line, who has 14 points in the game. He's a perfect 5 of 5 from the free throw line. Again, Metmetaj came into this game 6 of 8. So he has shot free throws well all year. Continues to do so as he hits the first. Xavier Long checks into the game, replacing Jeff Redband. And we have a timeout called. A little strategy here by Firebirds head coach Mike Riley, maybe trying to freeze the free throw shooter, just like they do in football, freezing the kicker. So we're tied at 74, timeout UDC. Folks, the University of the District of Columbia extends beyond its campus footprint, offering easy access to world-famous monuments, political intrigue, and cultural attractions everywhere you look. And education at UDC opens doors to opportunities that can only be found in the nation's capital. For more information, visit the UDC website at www.udc.edu. Also, UDC would like to thank our corporate partner, the Days Inn Connecticut Avenue. The Days Inn is a proud sponsor and next-door neighbor of UDC Athletics, located at 4400 Connecticut Avenue Northwest. Jackson Chandler, Nickerson, Sid Berry, and Butler remain in the game for UDC. A minute 26 left. It is Arif Mehmetaj at the free throw line. Now a perfect 6 of 6 from the stripe for 15 points in the game. He is 4 of 11 from the field as well. And gets the friendly roll around the rim on the second attempt. So now a 1-point Wildcats lead, a minute 23 left. Firebirds had their chance to extend their lead, could not do so. Now they've got to try and get back out in front. Butler finds Sidbury. Defender long all over him. Chandler does not use the screen, but still gets around his defender, then draws the foul with 1:04 remaining. Could hear that Daemen thinking the block was all ball. Maybe some contact on the lower body, however. So it's Kasim Chandler at the free throw line. He gets the first, now a perfect 7 of 7 from the stripe. He has 11 points, tied with Trayvon Butler for third on the team in scoring. Long checks out of the game for Daemen. Red band back in. Feel like they're going to be making this substitution, offensive, defensive substitution, pretty often here in this final minute. Speaking of substitutions, Chandler out for UDC. Matthews in. Maybe a bit of a better defender at the guard spot. Point guard spot, that is. Under a minute to go. Firebirds trying to hang on now. Up by one. Hamilton. The screen set for him. He drives. Jackson, the deflection. Offensive rebound by Mehmetaj. It's blocked. Ball is loose. Recovered by Hannah. And now a reach-in foul called. Such tough defense there by the Firebirds. Got a big offensive rebound. Offensive rebounding so key. Earlier in the day, we saw how key that was in the women's basketball game against Daemen. UDC women winning by 2, thanks in large part to a big offensive rebound off a missed free throw. Daemen has out-rebounded UDC by 10 this game, 38-28. They've out-rebounded the Firebirds on the offensive glass, 14-6. Hannah hits the first free throw. We are tied at 76 with just 36.8 seconds left. 6.8 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Hannah makes them both. Two clutch free throws and a timeout called by Daemen. This is a 30 second timeout called by the Wildcats. Since opening its doors in 2009, the University of the District of Columbia Community College continuously affirms its mission to provide opportunities for students to obtain the requisite skills of today's workforce and to prepare them for the demands of tomorrow. For more information, visit the UDC website at www.udc.edu. Firebirds shooting 47.3% from the floor this afternoon. Daemen 43.3%. UDC shooting much better from beyond the stripe, 50% compared to 31.6%. Both teams shooting well from the free throw line. Firebirds 13 of 14, Daemen 19 of 22. So they've just been there a few more times. Pretty evenly played ball game. Firebirds though now down by one. Say the slight edge is to UDC in terms of how well this game has been played, but score doesn't lie. As Chandler drives, puts one in from right in front of the hoop. No timeout called by either team, so we'll continue to play with UDC up one, and now the Wildcats spend their final timeout. With 19.9 seconds left, what will head coach Mike McDonald draw up for this Wildcats team. My guess is they try and get it to Metmatage. Metmatage or Hamilton. Supreme Hannah, though, is the leading scorer for Daemen with 23 points now, so he's a possibility as well. Let me tell you about some of the other scores going on around the East Coast Conference this afternoon. Told you about the final from earlier. St. Thomas Aquinas sneaking away with a 2-point win at Molloy. With 3:47 left in the second half, Queens and NYIT are tied at 67. Chestnut Hill, a 2-point winner at Roberts Wesleyan, 82-80, so a lot of close games. 17-21 remaining in the second half at Bridgeport. Bridgeport leads at home against Mercy, 37-30. LIA Post played American International today. No score update from that one. No timeouts left for Daemen, one remaining for the Firebirds. Daemen is able to take the lead. They'll likely spend their last one. Inbounds pass is to Hamilton. He's got Nickerson on him. Hannah gets open, drives, can't hit the layup, but a foul is called. Firebirds can't believe it. It wasn't up top for sure, but there may have been some contact down below. Maybe a little bit of a hip check. So Hannah back to the free throw line, where he is a perfect 8 of 8 from the free throw line. He's 6 of 11 from the field, 3 of 7 from 3, 23 points to lead all scorers. He's really come alive here at the second half, here in the second half, as in the first half he had just 7. So make that 24 points and we are deadlocked at 78. Xavier Long comes in for defensive purposes for Daemen, and now the Firebirds will spend their final timeout. UDC looking for its first win on its home court this season. And first win in conference play. Both these teams, for that matter, are looking for their first win in conference play. Daemen came into this game 5-2 on the year, 1-2 away from home. They have been on a long road trip, not all one continuous long road trip, but this is their third of four games on the third in a row of four straight games on the row, on the road. Their next game also on the road at Bridgeport next Saturday, December 10th. They are 4-0 at home this season, but 1-2 on the road. Made free throw here gives them a 1-point lead with 13 seconds remaining. Free throw is up and in. Hannah remains perfect at the line, now 10 of 10. Firebirds have the ball in the hand of Chandler, and a travel is called. Costly travel there. And now UDC will have to foul right away if they don't get a steal. Just 6.7 seconds left. Back to foul right away. They don't get a steal. If they can get a steal, that's gravy. They don't, so it's Metmatage who will head to the free throw line. Free throw shooting for both teams, just outstanding today. Twenty-four are the Wildcats from the line. That's 87.5%. So strategy now for UDC. 4.9 seconds left. That's plenty of time to get it, the ball into the front court. Likely going to have to take a desperation three, however. Either tie or try and win the game. Metmatage misses the first. So they can go for a two if they can get it down court fast enough. A layup, not out of the realm of possibility. only gold jerseys along the side of the lane. Second free throw is in. So 2-point Daemen lead. Nickerson races into the front court. Goes up with a layup, draws the foul right before the buzzer, and it was a blocking foul. So free throws coming up for Joseph Nickerson. Boy, how big are these? He makes them both. We head to overtime. Right before the buzzer sounded, the referee's now huddling up to make sure that the clock didn't expire. At this level, no instant replay. Referee's calling both coaches over. And it looks like the referees are explaining that it was a foul. And I think it was right before the buzzer sounded. Didn't get a look at the clock, but from what I heard, the whistle certainly blew right before the buzzer sounded. So it's Joseph Nickerson at the free throw line. He makes both. We go to OT with just 0.2 seconds left on the clock. He's able to hit the first. Clutch. So one more to send it into OT. And finally, the crowd comes alive. One more and this place will explode. Second one is in. We're headed to overtime. There is 0.2 seconds left. Not enough time to catch and shoot. So overtime, here we come. Will be a 5-minute overtime period. And new life for the Firebirds. How clutch was Nickerson at the free throw line. He's a perfect 5 of 5 from the free throw line. Now tied with Sidbury for the team lead with 19 points. No free throws bigger than those. And now UDC shooting free throws at a 93.8% clip for this game. Both teams outstanding comes to the free throw line this afternoon.
I have the best job of anyone I know. I am surrounded by intensely committed, hard-charging lawyers for social change, lawyers who care about social justice, staff who are here at the law school because of our mission. Our law school has a completely different, pervasive educational methodology. We learn by doing. So instead of taking a course where you read books and articles about juveniles enmeshed in the criminal justice system, at the David A. Clark School of Law, you represent children charged with crimes or children who are in the abuse and neglect system or children with special education needs in court or in administrative hearings. You actually, as a student with close faculty supervision, change their lives. And that's how you learn.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship. Found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
Now, let's take a look at the foul situation. There are two players for UDC, Khalil Jackson and Anthony Matthews, who are one foul away from fouling out. For Daemen, they have no one with more than three personals. Darius Garvin has the most with those three personals. This is where maybe the advantage of having a bit of a deeper bench comes into play for Daemen. We'll have a tip-off at half court. Khalil Jackson will take it for UDC. Going up against Xavier Long. Jackson, Sidbury, Butler, Matthews, and Nickerson on the floor for UDC. Tip is up. And it's a violation by Daemen. So it'll be UDC basketball. The guy who tipped it up can't be the one to secure it. So it will be Nickerson to inbound. And the referee explaining something to Firebirds head coach Mike Riley. Not sure what that discussion is about, but that's the reason for the little bit of the delay here. Nickerson inbounds to Matthews. We'll get the offense set up. Jackson sets a screen. Matthews tried the give and go with Jackson. Didn't get to Jackson. Got to Butler, who feeds Jackson, and he can't hit the layup from underneath. So we remain tied at 80. 4:40 left. Firebirds have used 9 players in this contest. Drive and a jump ball will stay Daemen possession. Daemen has used 11, so they've got a little bit of fresher legs. Long checks out of the game, red band in for him. For the Wildcats, 4:30 remaining this overtime period. And offensive foul called on the Wildcats. It will be UDC basketball. Matthews works it into the front court. Because if it was an offensive foul, no free throws for UDC. But now we have a defensive foul, so free throws coming up. Fouls don't reset in the overtime period, so as that is the 9th team foul on the Wildcats, 1-1 free throws now coming up for Anthony Matthews. Anthony Matthews transferred to UDC from Highland Community College prior to the start of this season. 6-foot junior, Staten Island, New York native. Making his first trip to the free throw line this afternoon. He sinks the first. Came into this game a perfect 5 of 5 from the free throw line this year. Kyle Williams and Cameron Outlaw, the only 2 Firebirds who have played in this game who have not scored for UDC. Matthews now with 4 points, it's 82-80. With 4:19 remaining in this contest, in the overtime period, that is. Firebirds by 2. Hannah. The screen set by Memetage. Drives, runner is in. Good looking runner there, soft touch by Hannah. Daemen returning 15 players from last year's team that played in the ECC Tourney Championship game here at the UDC Sports Complex. They're used to this building and used to the pressure. But so is Jackson, hitting the jumper from the elbow. Again, puts UDC's lead at 2 with 3:37 left in OT. Hannah drives, runner off the glass this time. How about that kiss? 2 great drives by Hannah with some soft touch on it. Now Matthews into the front court. Nickerson. The Jackson. Finds Sidbury cutting. Gives it back to Matthews. Jackson with 8 on the shot clock. Drives. Tries to feed. Sidbury pass was off. It would have been a good look for Sidbury, who's been tremendous from 3-point range this afternoon, but hasn't gotten too many good open looks from the corners of late, as he was getting earlier in this game. 3 minutes exactly remaining, tied at 84. Now a chance for the Wildcats to take the first lead of OT. Their first lead, that is. Red band, the three off the mark. Rebound to Butler. 2:45 remaining in the overtime period. Matthews. Shouting out instructions for the rest of the men on the floor. Hands off to Nickerson. Nickerson drives, kicks back to Matthews. Jab step, gets himself open for three. Doesn't get the friendly roll. Bounced a couple times off the rim before falling out. Now Garvin drives, beautiful no-look pass. And the three from Hamilton doesn't go. Butler harassed, but not fouled in the backcourt. Now Matthews slows the tempo down. 2:07 left in overtime. Matthews kicks right to Nickerson. Has the ball knocked away, recovers. Butler drives and draws the foul. So Trayvon Butler from Lakewood, New Jersey. He went to high school here in the D.C. area. Went to Eleanor Roosevelt. He's heading to the free throw line for just the second time this season. Came into this game 2 of 2 from the stripe. He has 11 points. And he's able to hit the first. Alex Borges and Jeff Redband check out for Daemen. Lalka. Back in. By the way, Metmataj now with 4 personals for the Wildcats. No one's fouled out of this game. UDC up by 2, 1:50 remaining. Hannah dribbles right. Screen set by Metmataj. He's double teamed. Hamilton now drives on Nickerson. The three from Garvin won't go. Daemen has, as a team, struggled from distance. Now 6 of 22. Firebirds shooting a much better clip. They're shooting 47.8%. About 20 percentage points higher than the Wildcats. Nickerson with 10 on the shot clock. Beats Jackson for 3. No good. Butler, the offensive rebound. Beats Sidbury. Firebirds elect to use some clock. Sidbury had a good look at it, but passed it up. Interesting choice. I don't mind the using clock choice, but Sidbury dangerous from deep. He is the guy you want shooting an open three. Nickerson finds Butler. Down to 7 on the shot clock. Matthews drives. Feeds Butler. The short jumper misses everything, and that's a shot clock violation. So it is Daemen basketball with 37.2 seconds left. 7.2 second difference between shot clock and game clock. And now the Wildcats will use their one and only timeout of the overtime period. Full timeout for the Wildcats. UDC still has their lone time out of the overtime period. Let's look at sort of how we got to this point. Firebirds the better shooting numbers from the field, but Daemen getting to the free throw line 6 more times than UDC. Both teams shooting very well from the free throw line. Turnovers pretty even. UDC with 16 this game. Daemen with 15. Points off turnovers pretty even as well. 15 for the Firebirds, 13 for the Wildcats. Big rebounding disparity in favor of the Wildcats, 41-32 in that department. Firebirds out assisting the Wildcats, 15-13. Blocks and steals both going the way of UDC as well. UDC up by 6 in the steal department, 9-3. Men scoring favoring the Firebirds as well, despite the Wildcats' manpower advantage when it comes to their deep bench. It will be Darius Garvin to inbound the ball for Daemen. Supreme Hannah, Xavier Long, Dion Hamilton, and Arif Netmataj on the floor. Again, 7 second difference between shot clock and game clock with UDC up by two. Hamilton gets it to Hannah. Pump fakes. Hamilton. Back to Hannah. Drives on Jackson with eight on the shot clock. Tries to feed it off, recovered by Sidbury, and he gets fouled with 11.4 seconds left. And now it's going to come down to free throws. Can the Firebirds, who've been so good at making their free throws all game, continue to make those freebies and put this one out of reach, make it a two-possession game? 11.4 seconds, still a lot of time remaining. And it's, again, Reggie Sidbury at the free throw line. This is his first trip to the line. Gets the first. Now with 20 points. Eclipses the 16 he had the Firebirds last game. Well above his season average of 11 coming into this contest. Second free throw, good as well, makes it 88-84. 4 point contest, 11.4 left. Garvin to Hannah, chucks up the three, misses off the backboard. Jackson soars in for the rebound, and Daemen has to foul again with 4.6 seconds left. And that pretty much seals this one, folks. Sure, another free throw made or two by Jackson would be nice, but since it's a two-possession game, it'd be hard for Daemen to try and make two more shots with just 4.6 seconds remaining. So it looks like UDC is headed to their second win of the season. They'll improve to 2-4 and 1-1 here at home, while they'll start off conference play with a 1-0 mark. Meanwhile, Daemen is going to fall to 0-2 in conference play, 5-3 overall, and 1-3 when playing away from home. So that does it. Your final, UDC wins it 90-84. And for head coach Mike Riley, his record now improves to 25-64. Overall, as the head coach at UDC, Mike McDonald, who just won his 300th career coaching game a little while ago, just a couple games ago, I should say, his record falls to 302 and 249. Folks, I want to thank you so much for tuning into this one. What a game you were treated to. Firebirds a winner by a final of 90-84. UDC now 2-4 on the season, 1-1 at home, 1-0 in conference play. Daemen 5-3 overall, 0-2 in conference play, 1-3 on the road. This has been a production of UDC Firebirds Basketball by University of District of Columbia Television for all the good, hardworking men and women involved with both the UDC Athletic Department and University of the District of Columbia Television. I'm Eli Pearlstein saying good night from the UDC Sports Complex. Please do.